Hey friends, Azure Static Web Apps is a service that can automatically build and deploy your full stack web app from a code repository to the cloud. But did you know it also enables you to achieve close to single digit millisecond response times for your users anywhere in the world? Simona Cotin is here to show me how it all works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Simona, who's going to tell me how to accelerate my websites with Azure Static Web Apps. How are you?
Hi, Scott. Hi, everyone. I'm doing well. Thank you so much. How about you, Scott?
I am very well. I'm very well. You know, I recently moved about 9 of my websites over to Azure Static Web Apps. Everything's faster and better, and it's saving me money. And it sounds like you have some tips to make it even better for me.
Yeah, and I'm so, so happy that everything worked out very well with moving your websites. I've moved some of mine as well, and I hear this story over and over again. And something else that we usually talk about when we talk about Azure Static Web Apps is site performance. And based on our customers' feedback, we know that this is crucial when they're creating applications for the modern web. We know that it has a direct impact on user experience. It has a direct impact on search engine rankings. We all want to be there on the first entry on the first page of a search engine. And ultimately, it does have a strong impact on our business as well. And with Azure Static Web Apps, we are committed to really building a platform that helps you deliver the best results for your users. And as you know, Azure Static Web Apps is a purpose-built content delivery network, a CDN, that makes your global applications fast. It makes them highly available, and it really allows you to scale as your users are coming in. So what we usually do is we globally distribute and cache your static content across the world so that your users can access your application as fast as possible, regardless of where they are around the world. And today I'm thrilled to announce and demo the public preview of Azure Static Web Apps Enterprise Grade Edge, which is powered by Azure Front Door. And it enables even faster page loads, enhanced security, and higher availability for your global applications. And this is a fully managed experience with absolutely no configuration required or any other additional code that you might have to write. So I can go ahead and share my screen so I can show you how this works. All right, so what I have here is a production application. This is a Gatsby application that is already running on static web apps at shoplamp.xyz. And this is where, this is an application that we're going to enable Enterprise Grade Edge for. So as you can see here, this is the usual portal screen that you would see for your static web app. And we have this new menu item here on the left-hand side called Enterprise Grade Edge. And when I go to this page, there's a couple things happening. Before I can enable this Enterprise Grade Edge, there's two prerequisites. So one is we build this feature for production applications. So you have to be on a standard hosting plan in order to be able to take full advantage of this feature. But also you have to have your custom domain set up. As you can see here, I've set up my shoplamp.xyz custom domain, and I'm ready to go and enable the Enterprise Grade Edge by checking this impressive checkbox.
So by default, when you make a standard or a free or a low SKU standard static web app, where does it live? It lives, like, for example, I think mine's like North Central, so it's in Chicago somewhere, right? And if someone is going to access that from, you know, from Europe somewhere, the limit really is the speed of light, right? The electrons can only get there so fast. So their latency is going to be, it could be a couple hundred milliseconds, it could be 50 milliseconds. It's going to be whatever the static, you know, whatever the work that has to happen on the cloud is, plus the speed of light and their own connection and all those kinds of things. And those static web apps are hosted in one place, right, by default. Is that correct?
So we have a single place that we attach the static web apps serverless APIs and staging environments. But then on deployment, we actually globally distribute your static content across the globe. So your Northern Europe, or let's say your user from Switzerland, where I'm currently based, will actually access a point of presence that's closest to Switzerland rather than the North America point of presence.
I see. Okay, fantastic. And then when we click this Azure, when this magic button here, the enterprise grade edge, we're going to get that load balancing across all the potential places. Like you said, 118 plus points of presence. So literally whatever is closest to my house is going to be where that data is served from, right?
Exactly. And that's what enterprise grade edge is bringing us. It's an enhanced or a bigger, larger, much larger number of points of presence. And it's all backed by Microsoft's global edge network.
Interesting. And I see right there, it says powered by Azure Front Door. I recently turned on Azure Front Door for Hanselman.com. So when you visit my personal website, it's Azure Front Door, but I had to go in and make a front door. I had to configure it. I had to move my certs over there. I basically did a bunch of setup and it was very powerful. But it took me some time and it was a little bit, it took some reading and some education. Are you going to hit save and then I'm going to have to go and do all of that front door stuff and it's going to be a bunch of configuring?
No, so once you hit save here and you confirm that you want to enable enterprise grade edge for your application, then everything will be magically managed for you. So we will not have to create a new instance. We will not have to configure, let's say, Azure Static Web Apps to restrict traffic only for Azure Front Door. Everything will be managed in the background for you by Azure Static Web Apps.
That's cool. Okay. So you're using Front Door, but you're preventing me from having to worry about it. You're kind of hiding it from me. You're letting us sit on top of that checkbox and you're instituting best practices for SSL offload, acceleration, CDNs. You're including all those points of presence. I could do that manually, but now I don't have to. I just hit the checkbox.
That is exactly correct. And I think we've learned from our customers that, and from our users that, through, for example, the managed functions as well, there's a lot of benefit in this simplicity and having this ability of enabling functionality that's relevant for web applications that will improve productivity and it will improve the user experience with a single, the power of a single checkbox. I think that's very powerful. And that's what we're doing here as well.
You know, what I think is so great about that is that we talk about this single checkbox or a slider bar somewhere in Azure. And those are really encapsulating best practices. There's decades of thought in how to do a global network. And I remember in the 90s, we would fly a consultant from Cisco or F5 networks or someone who knew what they were doing to come and pull wires and install an appliance. And we would have round robin load balancing, something that you can do in Azure Front Door in like a check, it takes you 5 minutes. We would have to fly a consultant in to help us do that. And I used to joke that I have a 3-page long resume and that the second page was scaling web apps. And then now it's a checkbox in Azure. So I just pull that second page out of my resume because it's all encapsulated in the best practices that we see in the cloud. And it's so amazing I hope that people appreciate the power behind a single checkbox. It is all the best practices of years of doing apps at scale. And it's so amazing. You could check this and then go to lunch and you've just made a global website.
Yeah. And I so love that story because it does remind me of the times when we had to do that as well. And I think here what we're doing is basically almost like renting a tiny bit of the brain of everyone else that has contributed to building this awesome product. And as you can see, it does take a while to actually enable this enterprise grade edge. It usually takes about 20 minutes. And I did prepare another application that we can test What I really want to show you here is the impact of enabling the enterprise-grade edge on our static web app. And the way we're gonna test that the impact on performance is using this tool called loader.io, which allows us to track some metrics like response times and response counts and bandwidth. And I can go ahead and run an existing test, which currently basically spins up 100 clients per second. And it runs this test for 30 seconds. And it goes to Azure Static Web Apps.site. So I'm going to go ahead and click run. And what we'll see here is our requests coming in. There's usually a warm-up time that I see while running these tests. But beyond that warm-up time, we can see that for 100 clients, we can consistently see this average response time of 10 milliseconds, 11 milliseconds, which is basically very impressive from my perspective as a response time for a static web app.
Wow. So and that makes me think about the speed of light, right? Like, and I keep coming back to the speed of light, right? How far can light go in 10 milliseconds, right? You're getting it down to as fast as can possibly be done. And there's a lot of stuff happening, but the idea that you can get a response back from a get in 10 milliseconds is just fantastic.
Yep. And we can stress this further. We can get up to maybe 1,000 clients, and we'll see that as we're running this new test, we're getting, again, 1,000 clients, but our speed and our response time remains constant at 10 milliseconds. Of course, as we're going to increase and as our applications are becoming viral and more people want to buy lamps, then we might experience some lower response times. But overall, I think these are very impressive results. And as you mentioned, it's like almost a point of presence next to my door.
Mm-hmm. And what's exciting about that is that while these are static apps, of course, like you mentioned that this was on Gatsby, if someone wants to go and back this application with an Azure function or some other serverless thing, they're going to also have the activity and then maybe put Azure Cosmos DB behind it. So you're going to have a global database, global serverless platform, and static web apps. It's so funny, you know, when you go to a startup and they have like a big TV in the lobby and it has a map of the earth up with a pin of all the places that they do business. It was always big companies that could get a pin. Oh, we have an office in Zurich. We have an office in Portland. Now, 1- and 2-person companies can use Azure Static Web Apps, Cosmos, and Azure Functions, and they can put 118 pins all over the world and say, we're a globally distributed application and we're ready for any traffic that the world can throw at us.
I love it. And I think this is especially important in the days that we are now, where everyone is spending most of their time online, and it becomes more relevant to have that kind of presence that CDNs and Azure can offer us.
Now, I did mention, though, that I have my own front door. Can I bring my own front door if I want more power, if I want to control pathing, or maybe, you know, manage certificates on my own?
Yep, absolutely. So we actually have this other option, which you can consider your bring your own Azure Front Door option, where you can manually configure Azure Front Door so that it uses Azure Static Web Apps as a backend for your front end, for your Azure Front Door instance. And you can configure your custom domain, your managed certificates there as well. And then we have this smooth integration as well, where you will see here that you can update your Static Web Apps config so that it only accepts traffic from and requests from Azure Front Door. And you can configure that to be your own instance of Azure Front Door.
Right. That's a great point. That allowed IP addresses is really important, because what you're saying is, you know, Azure Front Door is acting as a reverse proxy, and you don't want people to go around Front Door and get into your house another way. They got to go through the front door.
Through the door, yes.
Very cool.
Awesome.
So this is available now in preview?
Yeah, so it is available in public preview, ready for you all to go check it out either in the Azure portal, or you can also use Azure CLI to enable this feature, to disable it, or query for the status.
So I can go to Docs and check out Azure Static Web Apps, or if I already have an Azure Static Web App, as I do have 9, I'll go into the portal and I can just click on Enterprise Grade Edge and get started right away.
That is true. And if you want to learn more about this, you can check out the announcement blog post at aka.ms/swa-edge, or you can go try it yourself directly into the Azure portal, as Scott mentioned he would do.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much. This has been great.
Thank you.
All right. I am learning all about how to accelerate my website with Azure Static Web Apps today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.